stay tuned to see how I saved to pay off a credit card with just extra money I was probably wasting on lunch. Okay, let's finish off this April challenge. What I did, I colored in the corresponding butterflies with the particular number, and then I would put that amount of the butterfly value inside of a gold money envelope. It was a little harder than what I thought, but I did go ahead and pull it through. It was so pretty, so I just really could not even stop. The purple was worth either $10 or $20. I bubbled them in and colored them in so dark. But I did finish the challenge, and the colors we used were purple, yellow, blue. Big blue ink got a little weak, so we ended up having to use green. I think it was about, no, it was 30 envelopes because it was 30 days. And like I said, the first one was number one, and then they went from 1 to 30. It was 5 butterflies on each row. And I did put the last butterfly in the envelope. I just forgot to color it in. All right, let's count this money, y'all. man, I ain't even gonna lie, y'all. My hands got tired. I bit off more than what I could chew today. But we into the video too deep. We gotta finish it off. So I'm still counting out my money out of my envelopes. I am just on number 15, which means I got 15 left. So we just got to keep going till we get to the complete end so we can see how much cash we got from this savings challenge. I ain't gonna lie to either. Looking at them 20s was looking good. You know, when you putting them in there on the respective days, you're just not really thinking about it. You just put the $20 in there, or in my case, I would gather, you know, some money, and then I would fill in as many envelopes as I could. So sometimes I'd be a little ahead, and then sometimes I would be just behind. I would always go back and get caught up, because some days I'm just busy. I just sit the money to the side. I don't even think about it anymore. But seeing all these 20s together is looking good. This is an easier way to me sometimes to just pay off your creditor or creditors. You put the money in an envelope, a month, you pay them. Instead of the $75 a month or $50 a month, just pick one and pay it off. And as you know, after you finish paying off this one, you take this same money that you used to use to pay off this creditor and put it into the next creditor, starting from the smallest bill going to the highest bill. We start at the lowest bill because we all are creatures of animals. We want satisfaction. We want pleasure. We want to feel success. So it's always good to start up with the smallest bill, like a $300 credit card. And then you work your way up to the $25,000 one. But let's start with the $300. All right, let's continue to count. All right, we gotta put all these ones together. It'd be good if it was hundreds, but we'll take our ones right now. It was so many of them, I had to split this up. I ended up getting a lot of ones because it was $5, $10, $20. And sometime I'd have enough, I gotta pay myself some more money later, and I was just doing it ones. Ones was just the safest bill, I think, to keep. And sometime I would actually get change for my fives and tens and then change it into ones just in case I had to bubble in a five versus a ten. Okay, ones would always work. It was so many ones, I had to count them in groups, write it down, and then count the next ones. let's get down to these 20s, okay? The ones took a lot out of me. Let's get down to these 20s. Look like it was, let me see. Write this down, 140. But let me recount this again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, 140. 140 from the 20s. Yes, I had to bring out my calculator to get a total. This 30-day April challenge actually gave me $325 to save to go toward paying off one of my credit cards. So it's a good challenge. Thank you guys for coming.